The Philippine government declares a 10-day period of national mourning following the passing of former President Fidel Ramos. All Philippine flags will fly at half-staff during this period, while soldiers will wear black armbands for a month. An 8-gun salute was fired from dawn until dusk in the Philippine Army's headquarters in Taguig in honor of Ramos, who was also a former chief of staff of the armed forces. Ramos's cabinet members and staff remember him as a patriot and a leader who helped the Philippines stay afloat at a time when other nations were at the deficit.
Isa pa yung nakikita ko mga comments ngayon na siya si Boy Benta. Boy Benta, di ba? The privatization. Parang yung connotation kasi ng ngayon, parang binenta mo lahat ng ari-arian ng gobyerno. But at that time, coming out of the economic crisis, coming out from the EDSA revolution, wala naman pondo ang gobyerno, di ba? So what do you do? Instead of raising taxes, di ba, you have to tap the white elephant assets of the government.
To him, politics is what is good for the country. I would follow his lead, I'd follow his qualities, because I knew it was born out of his experience also as being involved in the law and order sector of our country. During those times, he gave the full support for the prosecution of those who have transgressed the law.
Ramos's family has yet to give details about his wake and burial.
Former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo also paid her respects to Ramos. She described him as one of the greatest Filipinos of the 20th century and a giant among Philippine leaders. She also lauded the former chief executive for being a so-called stabilizer amid coup attempts during her administration and that of former President Corazon Aquino. Arroyo calls on Filipinos to celebrate Ramos's life and emulate his love for country.
The international community also paid tribute to late President Ramos. China hailed Ramos's contribution in improving ties between Manila and Beijing. Japan's envoy, who called Ramos a good friend, says his leadership will never be forgotten. For U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines, Mary Kay Carlson, she will always remember Ramos for his contributions to Manila and Washington's bilateral ties. As for the European Union, it called Ramos a friend of the bloc and an icon of the EDSA revolution. Russia also honoring the late Philippine president. Its embassy says Ramos's administration opened a new milestone in the ties of the two nations. And for Germany's ambassador to the Philippines, Ramos successfully advocated for stronger Philippine-Germany trade relations, deepening the partnership of the two countries.
The Philippines on Monday also remembered one of its former leaders, the late President Corazon Aquino, who died 13 years ago on August 1st. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was among those who sent flowers to Mrs. Aquino's tomb at the Manila Memorial Park in Parañaque. 36 years ago, this would have been unimaginable, as the late democracy icon led the ouster of Marcos Sr. through a 1986 EDSA People Power revolt. Former Vice President Lenny Robredo was among those who remembered Mrs. Aquino. Robredo called her a symbol of hope, whose grace and quiet strength, she said, led the country through the dictatorship. Former Senate President Franklin Drilon also paid tribute to his former boss. Drilon, who once served as Cory Aquino's Justice and Executive Secretary, urged today's leaders to follow the principles that the democracy icon exhibited in office. Cory Aquino died at the age of 76 in 2009 after a years-long bout with colon cancer.